Welcome to a lesson on the plurality voting method. In this lesson, we'll define the plurality voting method, determine winners of elections using the plurality method, define the Condorcet fairness criterion, and also find a Condorcet winner. The plurality voting method is probably the method you're most familiar with, where the choice with the most first preference votes is declared the winner. Ties are possible and would have to be settled through some sort of runoff. This method is sometimes mistakenly called the majority method or majority rules, but it is not necessary for a choice to have gained a majority of votes to win, where a majority is over 50% of the votes. So it is possible for a winner to have a plurality without having a majority. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. A survey asked to rank which West Coast states people prefer to live. The results are below. Use the plurality method to select the winner. We're looking at the preference table here. C equals California, O equals Oregon, and W equals Washington. Notice if we find the sum of these values here, we can determine the total votes is 300. To determine the plurality winner, we'll determine how many first choice votes California received, then how many first choice votes Oregon received, and then how many first choice votes Washington received. Well, California received 75 plus 94 first choice votes, where 75 plus 94 equals 169. Oregon received 51 plus 12 first choice votes, which is 63 first choice votes. And finally, Washington received 43 plus 25, or 68, first choice votes. So in this case, notice that California received the most first choice votes, and therefore California is the plurality winner. Notice how in this case, California received 169 first choice votes out of 300, which is approximately 56.3%, which is more than 50%, and therefore California would also be the majority winner. But remember, a winner does not have to be a majority winner to be the plurality winner. Let's take a look at a second example, where here a small group of college students ranked the best destination for spring break, where S equals San Diego, L equals Lake Havasu, and R equals Rocky Point. Again, by finding the sum of these values here, we can determine there are a total of 17 votes. Notice San Diego received a total of 4 plus 4, 8 first place votes. Lake Havasu received a total of 2 first place votes. And Rocky Point received a total of 5 plus 2, or 7 first place votes. And since San Diego received the most first choice votes, or first place votes, San Diego is the winner. Notice in this case, San Diego received a total of 8 first place votes out of 17, which is approximately 47.1%. So notice how here, even though San Diego is not the majority winner, it still is the winner using the plurality method. This leads us to a discussion about what can be wrong about the plurality voting method. If there are three or more choices, it is possible that a choice could lose, but when compared in a one-to-one comparison, could be preferred over the plurality winner. And this violates what's called a fairness criterion, where the fairness criteria are statements that seem like they should be true in a fair election. The first fairness criterion we'll consider is called the Condorcet criterion, where if there is a choice that is preferred in every one-to-one comparison with the other choices, that choice should be the winner, and we call this winner the Condorcet winner or Condorcet candidate. Let's take a look at two more examples. This is the example that we saw before, where we know the plurality winner was San Diego with a total of 8 votes. But now we want to find the Condorcet winner. So to find the Condorcet winner, we'll do a one-to-one comparison with our three options. So we'll compare San Diego versus Lake Havasu. We'll compare San Diego versus Rocky Point. And we'll compare Lake Havasu versus Rocky Point. To do the one-to-one comparison with San Diego and Lake Havasu, we would ignore Rocky Point. So we'll ignore Rocky Point here, 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 and here. Remember, we have a total of 17 votes. So of the 17, San Diego is preferred over Lake Havasu, 4 plus 4 plus 5 times. So that would be 8 plus 5 or 13. So San Diego wins over Lake Havasu, 13 to 4. Now we'll compare San Diego to Rocky Point. So we'll ignore Lake Havasu. So notice San Diego beats Rocky Point here and here, but notice how Rocky Point wins here, here, and here. And therefore, for San Diego versus Rocky Point, the vote is 8 to 9. Notice in this one-to-one comparison, Rocky Point wins. And then finally, we want to consider Lake Havasu versus Rocky Point. So now we'll ignore San Diego. So Lake Havasu is preferred over Rocky Point here and here. And therefore, Lake Havasu versus Rocky Point would be 6 to 11. Now looking at these one-to-one comparison, notice how Rocky Point beats Lake Havasu here, and Rocky Point also beats San Diego here. Therefore, Rocky Point always wins in a one-to-one comparison, and therefore Rocky Point is the Condorcet winner. So even though San Diego was the plurality winner, under the Condorcet fairness criterion, Rocky Point should be the winner. Let's take a look at one more example. We want to find the Condorcet winner or Condorcet candidate if there is one. So the candidates are A, B, and C. So we'll do a one-to-one comparison. We'll have A versus B, A versus C, and B versus C. Notice the plurality winner would be C with a total of 16 first choice votes. So for A versus B, we'll ignore C. So A would win over B here and here. So A versus B would be 31 to 10. Next, for A versus C, we'll ignore B. Notice A wins only here. So A versus C would be 15 to 26. And then for B versus C, we'll ignore A. Notice how B wins here, and C wins here and here. So B versus C would be 10 to 31. So again, looking at these two here, notice C wins over B, and here C also wins over A, and therefore candidate C is the Condorcet winner. But notice how C is also the plurality winner here. I hope you found this helpful.